Welcome back to our show, We Connect. Apart from billiards, you've also written this book that's been doing very well. I was reading about it. It's an amazing philosophy, and let's talk about what you're actually saying in this book.
The book is Success Versus yes. Joy, and before I talk about the philosophy, I'll just briefly tell you how the book really came
yes.
about. So in 2000, I went through this phase of, is there more to life than just this sport? And I think as part of that questioning that arose in my mind, I think the book came out. But a lot of credit for this book goes to my friend Sunil Agrawal, who's co-authored it. And he was the one who kind of came to me and said, you've done something right. I want to find out what you did right. So the idea of the book was his, the story was mine. The philosophy is simple. I have spent 35 years trying to understand concentration, and I think the gist of that book is that you need to live in the moment, and the gist of the book is that concentration is nothing but the intellect supervising the mind to remain in the present, and our mind has a mind of its own. So it's a constant process that we need to go through to try and rein our mind if we want to kind of achieve better and better levels of concentration.
But after so many years of playing this game, do you still find that you have to go through this process of getting yourself to concentrate? Do you have to prepare very much before you actually get to the table?
I think it becomes part of your existence itself. It becomes, after a point, part of life. But having said that, like I said, our minds have a mind of their own, and no matter what you do, a zillion thoughts cross your mind, and it's still sometimes it's a conscious process that you go through. And I do believe that eventually lifestyle and what you do outside of the profession that you're in, and if you maintain an uncluttered lifestyle, I do believe that helps in kind of increasing your concentration levels.
Right. Now you're here in Chennai to actually play at the alumni tournament that's going on at the alumni club. Are you finding it, has it been well organized? I mean, is it all going as you thought it would?
Oh yeah, superb. We have pockets of interest in billiards and snooker, and what is heartening for me is that this tournament actually came about because there was a member of the club who just donated some money and said, get the best tables in the world, and they got it, and as part of kind of opening up the new tables, they said, let's have a tournament, and they've invited the top players from the country. So it's so heartening to see that this kind of interest exists, even though it may be in pockets.
Indeed. Of course, you also run your own travel agency, and where is the time, for heaven's sake, to be doing? I mean, where do you get the time? Or is this another one of your concentrating points?
No, well, I think I'm just fortunate. I've got great people who kind of look after the travel business. I don't spend much time in that. I don't put in my mental bandwidths into that business at all. I think my profession remains the sport, and I focus on the sport more than I focus on anything else.
Do you see yourself playing for the next 10 years, 15 years?
I don't plan, and I don't see myself what I'm going to be doing after 10 or 15 years. I know that for the next 1 year I will be playing. I think I plan, or I look 6 months to 1 year at a time. And like I mentioned at the start, I'm 48 today. I don't think I'll be playing for another 10 or 15 years. But I know I'm going to be playing for the next one or, at least 1 year.
Do you play any other games, Geet Sethi?
I play golf. I kind of indulge a little bit in that. It's great for a billiard and snooker player who's always cooped up in this,
in a smoky environment.
Used to be
often,
smoky.
Now this non-smoky.
Yeah, but it's still an environment which doesn't have fresh air. So it's great to get out on the, into the open fresh air in the morning and kind of. So I think the two sports complement each other, and it's nice to go out and get some fresh air in the morning.
And can we see you now turning up and becoming a golfing champion?
No, it's too late for that, Jennifer.
No, not at all. I don't accept that either, by the way.
Well, like I said, the competitive instincts are so sharp nowadays, and I can't think of myself as doing anything else, because for the first 30 years of my conscious youth were all spent in gaining skills in one particular thing, and you can't at the highest level can't really go out and do everything.
How about that saying about billiards? being a sign of misspent youth. Would you agree with that, just on that final note?
Not at all. It used to be when, you know, the age limit for us to enter the billiard room used to be 21. Mm. But today at 21, Pankaj Advani has already won, you know, he had won 3 or 4 world titles at the age of 21. So, no, not at all.
I'll give you that, Geet Sethi. I'll give you that. Thank you so much for being me today. Really appreciate your time.
Jennifer.
Well, that's all we have for you on We Connect. Remember that this is NDTV Hindu. This is your program. This is your channel. We'd love to hear from you. Give us a call, 99413-2222. That's all for now. Take care. Bye for now.